Hello, Mahachi. Good day. How are you?
Oh, afternoon.
Good afternoon.
I'm good.
Happy to hear that. Okay, good.
How about teacher?
I'm fine, thank you. Okay, we will wait a little bit, like 2 minutes for your friends to join, and then we will start it, okay?
One is my problem in the listening.
What is your problem?
I don't know. I think it's an easy one, but the problem. Like I listen the alphabet and the number. Usually it's the section one say easy or something, right? But I don't know why I can't hear properly. I can't hear right.
Okay. You mean you cannot answer the questions? This is the problem.
Yeah, like the talk as look like a simple one, like the phone number maybe.
Okay, Margie, could you tell me that when you Yes, I'm just connecting the battery. Sorry. Would you just tell me that when you have listening questions, what do you do first?
Like when we listening test, when we listen hear the listening test,
Okay.
we are, I don't know why, I don't have focus on it, I don't know, but I can't focus the number and alphabet. Maybe it's my
Okay, let me help you with something. Do you see this listening for today? One thing that I can tell you is that when it gives you like 30 seconds to read the questions, yes, you just read the questions and underline the words before the blanks, yeah, so that you know, for example, here on before and after, here you have year, so probably here you should have a
No.
number, yeah, like 2, 1, 1 year, first year, two, second year, I don't know, third year, something like that. You need to have a number. Welcome, Tam. Welcome, Aris.
Afternoon, teacher.
Good afternoon, dear. So this helps you a lot if within the time that you have, you just read the questions, okay? And the second point is that in the listening, it always moves in order. First, it replies number one, then it goes to number two, then number three, number four. If you just keep your eyes on the question, you keep your eyes on the question and you listen to the listening at the same time. You know, if you just try to make these two happen at the same time, you won't miss or lose any questions, any answers. Okay, you can just see that, oh, it's moving here. So this is the answer. Then it's moving here. This would be the answer. Okay. They all happen in an order and they are not going to be random. They don't go back and forth. Okay. So for today, try to use these two strategies that I gave you and see is it better or no. Okay.
Okay.
Thank you.
I think
So,
I didn't practice enough. I don't enough practice.
Oh, maybe it could be
I
because of enough practice
am.
also. I am. What is Alan? Okay, so would you just yeah, Mayuko, hi, how are you?
I'm good, thank you.
Okay, good. Welcome. And Tam is good. Aris, are you fine?
Yeah, fine.
Okay, good to know that. Thank you. And Sother, hello, how are you?
I'm good.
Okay, how's life? Okay, you went. Is he there? Okay, Carol, how are you?
He's not fine.
Okay, good. So everybody keep your cameras on. We will start the listening class right now. We will have two sections of listening, and as usual, first we read the questions and then we listen to the listening. Okay, I start with the first name in my list. I say it is Tam. Tam, would you start reading the questions? Tam, unmute yourself, please. Okay.
Sorry.
No problem.
Question 3 until 5. Complete the table below. Question 1 and 2. Complete the notes below. Why no more than 3 word? And all are number.
Very good. So answer. Everyone, please notice that this
example
is no more than 3 words. Okay, and or a number. So you are allowed to write 3 words. Yeah. Okay. Yes, please. Example. Okay.
Example. Type of job required. Answer part time.
Good. Thank you. Good. Okay. Carol, you start with question number 1, please.
Should I read the example?
No, you don't need to read the example. Question number 1.
Question number 1, student is dying.
Mm-hmm. Something. Yeah. Good. Yeah. Question number 1, Mayuko.
Student is studying something.
Okay. So for question number 1. So Tor, we don't hear you. Maybe you need to unmute yourself.
I'm sorry. I'm not comfortable right now.
Okay. Okay. So just listen to us. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Good. Thank you. Let's ask Aris question number 1.
Question number 1 and 2.
Only 1, Aris.
Oh, only 1. Okay. Student is studying.
Okay, Mahachi, question number 2. Mahachi, unmute yourself, please.
Okay. Student is in the year of the course.
Very good. Thank you. Tam, question number 2. Tam, do you hear me? Are you there?
Yeah.
Okay, number 2.
Number 2, student is in the number 2 year of the course.
Okay, very good. I remember last week you had a voice for this part. What was that voice? Did something like this?
Yes.
Yeah, good. What happened to Carol, question number 2.
Student is in the planned year of the course.
I hear you again. Okay, I can't.
Okay, very good. And let's ask Mayuko question number 2.
Student is in the 17th year of the course.
Very good, thank you. Then we move to question 3 to 5 and we will read them by Mahachi.
Question 3 to 5, complete the table below. Write no more than 2 words.
So everybody, please take care of it. Here you are allowed to write only maximum 2 words. Good,
not number, for each answer. Position available, where, and problem.
Very good.
The position, reception, the first column, the receptions, and where in the something. Mm-hmm. And problem evening lectures.
Yes.
And position number four, something.
Yeah.
And where in the child care center.
Very good.
Too early.
Lovely.
Position last one, clerical assistant.
Mm-hmm.
And where in the number five, something, evening lectures.
Very good, lovely. Thank you, Mayuko. Would you please read the table to us?
Reception.
Mm-hmm.
In the something.
Mm-hmm.
Evening lectures.
Mm-hmm.
Something in the child care center. Too early. Clerical assistant. Mm-hmm. In the something. Evening lecture.
Very good, lovely, thank you. And Tam, you please read also the table.
Table, mm-hmm. Complete the table below.
Tam, just read the table, not above it, okay?
Okay. Position available, receptionist, clerical assistant.
Tam, it's moving in this way, row by row. Receptionist. In the
evening,
mm-hmm.
lecture.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. Number four, in the child care center, too early. Clerical assistant in the number five, evening lecture.
Very good, lovely, thank you. And then we move to question six and the rest. Okay, we see another table here. So lots of tables today, yeah? Carol, start it, please.
Student DQ, name, Anita Newman, address, blank, room number blank, other skills, speak some Japanese.
Okay, thank you. Only six and seven. Mahashi, could you please read the instruction? Because we don't know how many words or numbers we can write.
Yeah, write no more than three words and or a number for each answer.
Very good. So here again, we can write three words. So it was three, two, again, three. Yeah, lovely.
Yeah, no more than three. And we can use the number too.
Of course.
Just a one number.
Yes. And would you read six and seven, please?
Student details. Name, Anita Newman. Address, number six something, room number seven something.
Very good, perfect, thank you. Aris, please.
Anita Newman.
Uh-huh.
Address, six, room number, other skills, speak some Japanese.
Very good. Okay, thank you. Good. Thank you. Let's read it by the final reader. Tam, she had it. Yes, Mayuko.
A name?
Yes.
Anita Newman, address, something, room number, something, other skills, speak some Japanese.
Very good, lovely, thank you. And the question number 8, 9, 10, we will read them all together. We start by Carol, please. Carol, position available, please unmute yourself.
Position available, blank at the English Language Center.
Very good.
Duties, respond to inquiries and blank.
Mm-hmm.
Time of interview, Friday at blank a.m.
Thank you, very good, excellent. Tam, please.
Position available, number 8, at the English Language Center.
Beauty respond to requirements and number 9 time of interview Friday at number 10 a.m.
Very good, lovely, thank you. And let's listen to Aris.
Response of available
position
mm-hmm. of position available and I did at the English language central detail
duties
response mm-hmm. response to inquiries and the number 9 something time of interview Friday at yeah.
Okay, very good. So is everybody ready for it? Okay, we're going to listen and please note down, write down your answers. Okay, we started. Let me just make sure it is computer sound.
The instructions and questions. Now turn to section 1. Section 1. You will hear a conversation between a student and a job advisor. First,
Mahachi, do you have any problems?
No, just to let you know, this sounds good.
Okay, good. Thank you so much.
Good questions 1 to 5. You will see that there is an example that has been done for you. On this occasion only, the conversation relating to this will be played first.
Good morning.
Oh, good morning. Is this room number 26?
Yes, that's right.
So, is this the Student Job Centre?
It certainly is. How can I help you?
Well, actually, I'm looking for a job, mm-hmm. a part-time job. Do you have anything available at the moment?
The student is looking for a part-time job, so part-time has been written in the space. Now we shall begin. You should answer the questions as you listen, because you will not hear the recording a second.
Room number 26?
Yes, that's right.
So, is this the Student Job Centre?
It certainly is. How can I help you?
Well, actually, I'm looking for a job, mm-hmm. a part-time job. Do you have anything available at the moment?
Yes. Are you a registered student? I'm afraid this service is only available to full-time students.
Yes, I am. I'm doing a degree in business studies. Here's my student card.
Which year are you in?
Well, I've been at uni for 4 years, but I'm in the third year because I took last year off.
Right. Well, let's just have a look at what positions are available at the moment. There's a job working at the reception desk at the sports centre for 3 evenings a week. That's Wednesdays, Thursdays and Fridays.
That sounds like fun, but unfortunately I have evening lectures, so that's not possible, I'm afraid. Is there anything during the day?
Okay, that's no good then. What about cleaning? There's a position for a cleaner at the childcare centre.
Right.
But you'd need to be there at 6 a.m. Does that appeal?
6 o'clock in the morning? Ooh, that's far too early for me, I'm afraid. I'd never make it that early in the morning.
Well, there was a position going in the computer lab for 3 days a week that might be okay. Ah, here it is. No, it's in the library, not the lab. Clerical assistant required. I think it mostly involves putting the books back on the shelves. Oh, no, hang on. It's for Wednesday and Friday evenings again.
No, I can't manage that because of the lectures.
OK, I'm getting the idea. Look, I'll just get a few details from you anyway, and then we can check through the list and see what comes up.
Before you hear the rest of the conversation, you have some time to look at questions 6 to 10. Now listen and answer questions 6 to 10.
We'll fill in the personal details on this application form first, if that's okay.
Yeah, that's fine.
Now, what's your name again?
Anita Newman. That's N-E-W-M-A-N.
And your address, Anita?
I'm in one of the halls of residence for postgraduate students. You know, International House.
Okay, that's easy. What's your room number there?
Room B569. B659. I always get that wrong. I haven't been living there very long.
Do you have any other skills? Typing, languages, that sort of thing?
Well, I speak some Japanese.
Right, I'll make a note of that. Now, let's see what else is available. What do you think of administrative work? There's a position for an office assistant at the English Language Centre.
That sounds interesting.
It's for 3 days a week, Monday, Friday and Saturday mornings. Interested?
I was hoping to have Saturdays free, but I need the work, so... Can you tell me what the job involves?
Yep, sure. It says here that you'll be required to deal with student inquiries and answer the phone.
I'm sure I can handle all that without a problem.
Great. Well, would you like me to arrange an interview for you? Say, Friday morning, around 10?
Can we make it a bit later? Unfortunately, I've got something to do at 10. Would that be okay?
Not a problem. How about 11:30? Hope it works out for you, Anita.
Me too. And thanks for all your help.
That is the end of Section 1. You will hear a conversation between a student and a job advisor. First, you have some time to look at questions 1 to 5. Example that has been done for you.
Room number 20. Actually, I'm looking for a job, a part-time job. Do you have anything available at the moment?
The student is looking for a part-time job, so part-time has been written in the space. Now we shall begin. You should answer the questions as you listen, because you will not hear the recording a second time. Listen carefully and answer questions 1 to 5.
Good morning.
Oh, good morning. Is this room number 26?
Yes, that's right.
So, is this the Student Job Centre?
It certainly is. How can I help you?
Well, actually, I'm looking for a job, a part-time job. Do you have anything available at the moment?
Yes. Are you a registered student? I'm afraid this service is only available to full-time students.
Yes, I am. I'm doing a degree in business studies. Here's my student card.
Which year are you in?
Well, I've been at uni for 4 years, but I'm in the third year because I took last year off.
Right. Well, let's just have a look at what positions are available at the moment. There's a job working at the reception desk at the sports centre for 3 evenings a week. That's Wednesdays, Thursdays and Fridays.
That sounds like fun, but unfortunately I have evening lectures, so that's not possible, I'm afraid. Is there anything during the day?
Okay, that's no good then. What about cleaning? There's a position for a cleaner at the childcare centre.
Right.
But you'd need to be there at 6 a.m. Does that appeal?
6 o'clock in the morning? Ooh, that's far too early for me, I'm afraid. I'd never make it that early in the morning.
Well, there was a position going in the computer lab for 3 days a week that might be OK. Here it is. No, It's in the library, not the lab. A clerical assistant required. I think it mostly involves putting the books back on the shelves. Oh, no, hang on. It's for Wednesday and Friday evenings again.
No, I can't manage that because of the lectures.
OK, I'm getting the idea. Look, I'll just get a few details from you anyway, and then we can check through the list and see what comes up.
Soon, just on the walk.
I can't see
it. I have it on if you need. Do you need now?
Not now.
Now listen and answer questions 6 to 10.
Thank you.
We'll fill in the personal details on this application form first, if that's okay.
Yeah, that's fine.
Now, what's your name again?
Anita Newman. That's N-E-W-M-A-N.
And your address, Anita?
I'm in one of the halls of residence for postgraduate students. You know, International House.
OK, that's easy. What's your room number there?
Room B-569. No, sorry, B-659. I always get that wrong. I haven't been living there very long.
Do you have any other skills? Typing, languages, that sort of thing?
Well, I speak some Japanese.
Right, I'll make a note of that. Now, let's see what else is available. What do you think of administrative work? There's a position for an office assistant at the English Language Centre.
Hmm, that sounds interesting.
It's for 3 days a week, Monday, Friday and Saturday mornings. Interested?
Oh, I was hoping to have Saturdays free, but I need the work, so... Can you tell me what the job involves?
Yep, sure. It says here that you'll be required to deal with student inquiries and answer the phone.
Oh, I'm sure I can handle all that without a problem.
Great. Well, would you like me to arrange an interview for you? Say, Friday morning, around 10?
Oh, can we make it a bit later? Unfortunately, I've got something to do at 10. Would that be okay?
Not a problem. How about 11:30? Hope it works out for you, Anita.
Me too. And thanks for all your help.
Okay, guys, we're going to move to question 11 to 20. Okay, section 2. Before that, because Sothar is new, let me ask him whether he's okay or he has any problems. Sothar, is everything okay with you? Do you know how we're going? Just no problems?
Yes, now I just like finish first. I'm going to home now, right now, so I'm not comfortable to study, but I can listen to all of you.
Okay, good. Thank you. Okay. So let's read the questions in section 2, just like section 1. Tam, please. Tam, unmute yourself. We don't hear you.
Question 11 until 16. Mm-hmm. Should the correct letter A, B, C, or C?
Mm-hmm.
Sponsored. Walking holiday. On the holiday, you will be walking for A, 6 days, B, 8 days, C, 10 days.
Mm-hmm. And 12?
12 was per position of the sponsorship money cost to Shirley Chatry. Mm-hmm. Monday going to Shirley, A, B, C.
Very good, thank you. Yes, Carol, please. 11 and 12, please.
On the holiday, you will be working for A, 6 days, B, 8 days, C, 10 days. 12, what proportion of the sponsorship money goes to charity? Money going to charity.
Thank you, Mayuko, please.
On the holiday, you will be working for 6 days, B, 8 days, C, 10 days.
Mm-hmm.
What proportion of the sponsorship money goes to charity? A?
Mm-hmm.
B, C?
Yes, and the money that goes to...
money goes to charity.
Very good, thank you. So we will move to question 13 and 14. Let's read them by Mahachi.
13, is workers sponsorship money goes to one. A, student, B, teacher, C, school.
Mm-hmm.
14, when you started the track, you must be A, interested in getting fit.
Mm-hmm.
B, already quite fit.
Mm-hmm.
C, already very fit.
Very good, thank you. Let's read them by Aris.
Okay. Each workers sponsorship money gets to one.
Aris, read it again.
Goes to one.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. A student, B teacher, C school.
Mm-hmm.
When you start the trip, you must be A, interested in getting fit. B,
fit.
B, already quite fit. Mm-hmm. C, already very fit. 15 as you work.
Okay, no. Just 13 and 14. Thank you. And let's read them by Tam again. 13 and 14, Tam.
13 is worker sponsorship money goes to one. A, student, B, teacher, C, school.
Mm-hmm.
14, when you start the trick, you must be a interested in getting lift. Be already quite fit.
Mm-hmm.
See, already really fit.
Oh, very good. Tam, read this word again, please.
Quiet.
This is quite.
Quiet.
Okay. Quiet, yes. Quiet means silent, but this is quite. Okay, good. Quiet. Thank you so much.
Okay. Thank you, question. Tisha.
You're welcome, yeah. 15 and 16, Carol, please. Am I right? Yeah, 13, 14. Oh, yeah. Yeah, 15 and 16.
As you work, you will carry all of your belongings,
mm-hmm.
some of your belongings,
uh-huh.
none of your belongings.
Mm-hmm.
The Senua region has a long tradition of making carpets.
Mm-hmm.
Weaving blankets, carving wood.
Mm-hmm. Very good, thank you. Let's ask Mayuko, please, 15 and 16.
As you walk, you will carry all of your belongings,
mm-hmm.
some of your belongings, none of your belongings.
Mm-hmm.
The Semira region has long tradition of making carpets, B, weaving blankets, C, carving wood.
Very good, lovely. Thank you. Mahachi, 15 and 16, please.
15, mm-hmm. have you walk, you will carry
mm-hmm.
A, all of your belongings,
mm-hmm.
B, some of your belongings,
mm-hmm.
C, none of your belongings.
Very good.
Mm-hmm. The similar regions have a long tradition of A, making carpets,
mm-hmm.
B, weaving blankets, C, carving wood.
Okay, carving wood. Very good. Thank you. Now we will move to question 17 to 20. And here we see another
blanket.
Yeah, fill in the blank type question. I need to make it smaller. Sorry, Marchi. Okay. So let's read it by Mayuko, please.
Complete the form below. Write one word only for each answer.
Okay, so please notice you're allowed to write only one word, no more. Yes, please, Mayuko.
Day one, arrive in Kishiba.
Mm-hmm.
Day two, rest day. Day three, spend all day in something. Day four, visit a school. Day five, rest day. Day six, see a something with old carvings. Day seven, rest day. Day eight, swim in a something. Day nine, visit a something. Day 10, depart from Kishiba.
Very good, thank you. We will read the same questions from 17 to 20 by. Leo, hello, how are you?
Hello, I'm good, thank you. How are you?
Fine, thank you. You were at work?
Yes.
Okay, good. So could you please just read the questions? I mean, read this table for us, okay?
Okay.
Yeah, these are listening questions. And after you read, we start listening to it. Okay, thank you.
So.
Yeah.
Yeah. Itinerary.
Mm-hmm. Itinerary, good.
Itinerary, day one, arrive in Kishiba. Day two, rest day. Day three, spend all day in a 17. Day four, visit a school. Day five, rest day. Day six, see a 18 with old carvings. Day seven, rest day. Day eight, swim in a 19. Day nine, visit a 20. Day 10, depart from Kishiba.
Very good. Thank you so much. Okay, let's listen to Carol. Carol, please unmute yourself. Yeah.
From day one.
Mm-hmm.
Day one, arrive in Kishiba. Mm-hmm. Day two, rest day. Day three, spend all day in a blank. Day four, visit a school. Day five, rest day. Day six, see a blank with all carvings. Day seven, rest day. Day eight, swim in a blank. Day nine, visit a blank. Day 10, depart from Kishiba.
Very good, lovely, thank you. So guys, are you ready for questions 11 to 20? So we'll play it.
Section 2. You will hear a talk given by a group offering a walking holiday to raise money for charity. First, you have some time to look at questions 11 to 16.
Leo, please try to answer, okay? Question
11. Now listen carefully and answer questions 11 to 16.
Good morning. I'm very pleased to have been invited along to your club to talk about our charity-sponsored walking holiday for education aid. I'll start by giving you a brief overview of what it entails. First of all, let me explain what we mean by sponsored here. This is where people promise to donate money to the charity if you achieve your goal, in this case to walk a certain number of miles. Basically, we are organising a 10-day holiday from the 6th to the 16th of November, with 8 days actual walking, trekking in the Samira Mountains. Let's have a look at some of the details. We require you to raise sponsorship money of at least $3,200, paying $250 of it up front as a deposit, and the rest in stages throughout the year. Out of this, about 35% will go on your expenses, and that leaves 65% guaranteed to go to the charity. Which brings me to the most important part. This trek is being specifically organised to help education in the Samira region. Last year, we helped train teachers for the disabled, and this year, we're focusing on the pupils. Each of the walkers' sponsorship money will go to help an individual special needs pupil in one of the mountain schools. In the second part of the talk, I'll be giving you a lot more details. But back to the basic information. Age limits. This is the second time we've run this kind of holiday, and on the first, we even had an 80-year-old. But we found it was wise to establish limits this time. You have to be at least 18, and the top limit is now 70, though you need to obtain a health certificate from your doctor if you are over 60 years old. Now, the Samira Mountains are among the highest in the world, but you mustn't be too daunted. We will mainly be trekking in the foothills only, although there will be spectacular views even in the foothills. However, you will need to be extremely fit if you aren't now and you're interested in coming with us. You have plenty of time to get into shape. You'll be sleeping in tents, so you must have quite a bit of equipment with you, but you will be helped by local assistants. Your bedding and so forth will be carried by them. We ask that you only walk with a small rucksack with needs for the day. I don't think I've really said enough about the marvellous area you'll be walking in. Let's have a look at some of the sights you'll be seeing. Apart from these spectacular snow-covered peaks and valleys, there are marvellous historic villages. The area's been famous for centuries for making beautiful carpets, although recently there has been a trend to move into weaving blankets and wood carving. The people are extremely friendly and welcoming. We deliberately keep the party small in size to minimise disruption to people and landscape.
Before you hear the rest of the talk, you have some time to look at questions 17 to 20. Now listen and answer questions 17 to 20.
I hope that there are still some people interested. I will be distributing leaflets at the end where you can find out more information. But just for the moment, I'll outline the itinerary, the main high points of the holiday. Obviously, you'll start by flying out to Kishba, the capital city, on day one. After a couple of days to acclimatise yourself, you'll start the trek on day three, walking through the enormous Katiba forest, which will take the whole of the day. Day four takes us higher up, going through the foothills, past a number of villages, and visiting a school for the disabled in Sohan. Then you have a rest day, that's day five, before going to the spectacular Kumi Temple, with 12th century carvings, set in a small forest by a lake. And that's day six, the highlight for many. We stay near there for day seven, because then comes the hardest day, walking through very mountainous country, but culminating in a swim in the Pate Falls. This is the highest waterfall in the region. Day nine is much easier, with part of the day spent in a village where they make some of the gorgeous red blankets. Then back down to Kishba and the journey home. So, you can see it's a pretty packed timetable.
Okay, we will go for the second time.
It's a pretty packed timetable.
I just try to move some parts to do it faster.
With 8 days actual walk, I'll start by giving you a brief overview of
11 to 16.
Good morning. I'm very pleased to have been invited along to your club to talk about our charity-sponsored walking holiday for education aid. I'll start by giving you a brief overview of what it entails. First of all, let me explain what we mean by sponsored here. This is where people promise to donate money to the charity if you achieve your goal, in this case to walk a certain number of miles. Basically, we are organising a 10-day holiday from the 6th to the 16th of November, with 8 days actual walking, trekking in the Samira Mountains. Let's have a look at some of the details. We require you to raise sponsorship money of at least $3,200, paying $250 of it up front as a deposit, and the rest in stages throughout the year. Out of this, about 35% will go on your expenses, and that leaves 65% guaranteed to go to the charity. Which brings me to the most important part. This trek is being specifically organised to help education in the Samira region. Last year, we helped train teachers for the disabled, and this year, we're focusing on the pupils. Each of the walkers' sponsorship money will go to help an individual special needs pupil in one of the mountain schools. In the second part of the talk, I'll be giving you a lot more details. But back to the basic information. Age limits. This is the second time we've run this kind of holiday, and on the first, we even had an 80-year-old. But we found it was wise to establish limits this time. You have to be at least 18, and the top limit is now 70, though you need to obtain a health certificate from your doctor if you are over 60 years old. Now, the Samira Mountains are among the highest in the world, but you mustn't be too daunted. We will mainly be trekking in the foothills only, although there will be spectacular views even in the foothills. However, you will need to be extremely fit if you aren't now and you're interested in coming with us. You have plenty of time to get into shape. You'll be sleeping in tents, so you must have quite a bit of equipment with you, but you will be helped by local assistants. Your bedding and so forth will be carried by them. We ask that you only walk with a small rucksack with needs for the day. I don't think I've really said enough about the marvellous area you'll be walking in. Let's have a look at some of the sights you'll be seeing. Apart from these spectacular snow-covered peaks and valleys, there are marvellous historic villages. The area has been famous for centuries for making beautiful carpets, although recently there has been a trend to move into weaving blankets and wood carving. The people are extremely friendly and welcoming. We deliberately keep the party small in size to minimise disruption to people and landscape.
Before you hear the rest of the talk, you have some time. Now listen and answer questions 17 to 20.
I hope that there are still some people interested. I will be distributing leaflets at the end where you can find out more information. But just for the moment, I'll outline the itinerary, the main high points of the holiday. Obviously, you'll start by flying out to Kishba, the capital city, on day one. After a couple of days to acclimatise yourself, you'll start the trek on day three, walking through the enormous Katiba forest, which will take the whole of the day. Day four takes us higher up, going through the foothills, past a number of villages, and visiting a school for the disabled in Sohan. Then you have a rest day, that's day five, before going to the spectacular Kumi Temple, with 12th century carvings, set in a small forest by a lake. And that's day six, the highlight for many. We stay near there for day seven, because then comes the hardest day, walking through very mountainous country, but culminating in a swim in the Pate Falls. This is the highest waterfall in the region. Day nine is much easier, with part of the day spent in a village where they make some of the gorgeous red blankets. Then back down to Kishba and the journey home. So, you can see it's a pretty packed...
Okay, some time for you to just rearrange your answers so that we can check your answers, okay? Okay, the ones that I ask, I just write whatever you just tell me. It means that they are not my answers, these are your answers. So some of them may be correct, some of them may not be correct. I start with Tam for question number one, two, and three. Tam, what did you answer for number one?
Business study.
business? You mean only the word business, or we also need study?
Business.
Start.
Yeah.
Okay, Michael, do you agree with Tam?
Yes.
Okay, so we will move to number two by Tam. Tam?
Number two, 4 years.
4 years, you mean? Mayuko, do you agree with it?
No.
No, what is your answer?
Third.
Ah, good, your answer is third. I don't know which one is correct. Good, lovely. Tam, number three?
Number three, I'm not sure.
You are not sure. Okay, we will ask Mayuko.
Sports center.
Very good. Lovely. Okay, question number 4, 5, 6 for Mahachi.
Hang on. Number four.
Mm-hmm.
Cleaner.
I'm not sure. So I will ask Carol. Carol, you agree with Mahachi?
Yes.
Okay, good. So you agree with it, Mahachi? Number five.
Library.
Yes. Okay. So Carol, you agree with it?
Yes.
Okay, good. And number six, Mahachi?
International.
Carol, you agree with it?
Yes.
Oh,
international.
International house. So you have different answers. Okay, no worries. Question number 7, 8, 9, 10 for Aries. And again, Mayuko, say correct or not. Okay, number 7, Aries.
Number 7 is maybe B659.
Mayuko, agree?
Yes.
Okay, good. So 8, Aris.
Sorry, Miss H, and 9, the answer is not the.
You didn't answer. Mayuko, what is your answer?
Office assistant.
Office assistant. I'm not sure. Okay, and number 9, Aries.
Number 9.
Aries, you are not sure about it. I will ask Mayuko.
Answer the phone.
Sorry, Mayuko, I didn't hear you.
Answer the phone.
Answer the phone. Okay. How many words are we allowed to write? Is that fine? We have 3 words.
I forget how many.
Three. Okay, good. Thank you, Mahachi. So Aries, number 10. Probably Aries doesn't have number 10.
11:30.
Thank you, Mayuko. Thank you. Aris' partner was Mayuko. Yeah. Okay, just the partner answers, not everybody, because it will be a mess in the class.
Yeah, I just think my answer is wrong. So.
Okay, no worries. No, I'm just talking to the others who replied instead of Mayuko. Okay, number 11, 12, and 13 for Mayuko. And we will double check it by Carol, okay?
B.
Carol, agree?
Yes, agree.
Okay, good. Mayuko, 12.
C,
Carol?
Yes, I agree.
Oh, very good partner. And then 13?
A.
F or A?
A.
Okay. Carol, agree?
Yeah.
Oh, lovely. Thank you. Okay, now we change your roles, okay, to Carol and Mayuko for the other 3 questions. And I need to create another table. 14, yes. Carol?
14, my answer is C.
Agree with it?
I'm not sure.
Okay, Mayuko is not sure. Okay, so 15.
15, my answer is B.
B, Mayuko agrees?
Yes.
Okay, and 16?
16, my answer is A.
Yes.
Your answer is A and yes for it. Okay, we will listen to 17 and 18, Tam and Leo. Tam and Leo.
17.
Uh-huh.
Walking.
Walking?
Yeah, not sure.
Okay, not sure. And Leo, what do you think? Unmute yourself, please.
Maybe, I'm not sure, forest?
Maybe forest, but yes. I think it is right. I don't remember. Okay, 18, Tam?
18, not sure.
And Tam, not sure. And what is Leo's answer?
I'm not sure, but I put small forest.
Again, small forest?
Yes, because...
But here you have to write only one word. Yeah, so probably this is not correct, okay? So we will do number 19 by Mahachi. And who is in the list who didn't work? Mahachi and Aris again. Mahachi, what is your answer for number 19?
Number 19.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not sure. I put the portrait.
Portrait?
Yeah.
Aris, what was your answer?
My answer.
Aris, if you are not sure, just tell me you are not sure, okay?
Yeah, no.
Okay, I will ask Mayuko. Everyone, yeah, let's listen to Mayuko. Mayuko, please. Number 19.
I didn't get it.
Oh, you didn't get it. Oh, so this. Sure? Yes, please, Mahachi.
Portrait, I think it's a T-R-E-Y.
Portrait. We will check it. We will check it. No worries. We will check it. Number 20. Okay, I will write your spelling as well. You spell what you say, Mahachi. What is your spelling?
I think P-O-T-R-E-Y.
P-O-T-R?
E-Y. Portrait.
E-Y, portrait.
I'm not sure.
We will check. Okay. And then let's listen to who was answering.
Village. Me.
Village. Okay, good. Village. And who was checking, Mahachi? Aris, Leo, or Aris? Aris, what is your answer for number 20?
Number 20, I think, you know, it's I think it's valid because it's excellent.
You mean the same answer?
Yeah.
Village. Okay, guys, so these are your friends' answers, but let's stop share these, but I will keep them to see how similar they are to the real answers. So now you can see the real answers. Okay, section one and section two. Okay, these are. So section one, number one, business. While I'm just reading, you also try to count your correct answers, okay? Business was correct, thank you. And third was correct, as Mayuko said, thank you. Sports center, very good, thank you. But you can put E at the end as the British one, okay? And cleaner, good. Library, good. Please notice that library is in the capital letter. It should be, it must be in the capital letter because in the column, if you look, all jobs, all places, locations are in capital letter. International House, thank you for Carol, thank you. And B659, thank you. I think it was Tam, yeah? Office assistant, Mayuko, thank you. Answer the phone again, thank you. 11:30, thank you. So most of you, I think, did very good for section one. So we will check section two, which is BCAC, BA, forest, temple, waterfall, village. Okay. Forest. So the second one, Eris, was not forest again. Leo was not forest again. It was temple. And waterfall. And the name of the temple, anyone remembers the name of the temple? It was also mentioned. Something like Katiba.
Kalipa or something.
Yeah, Katiba temple.
Kalaba or something.
Yeah, of course. Yeah, good. And waterfall. And finally, village. So please tell me how many correct answers you had so that I can put it here. And everyone, I mean, Miss May and also Miss Turner, they can just see your progress and compare it with every session. Okay, we have listening record sheet here. I add a new topic and I just write week two, listening, yeah? And I add your names, starting with Carol. Carol, yes, how many, Carol?
16.
Very good. Carol, tell me how many correct in section one you had. Okay, yeah, check it, please. Only section one.
Only section one, got eight.
Okay, good. As long as your section one is eight, above eight, it is perfect. Okay. Yes, Mayuko?
17.
Very good, lovely.
Section one is only 9.
Oh, excellent. I think very soon you can reach 10 for section one, Mayuko, because you are good and you should do it 10. You can do it, actually, I'm sure about it. Mahachi, please.
Just 13.
You mean 1-3?
Yep, 13.
Okay. 13. Very good, thank you. Marci, how many correct did you have in section one only?
What is section one?
10. Section 10? 10 out of 10?
No. 1, 2, 1. How many questions?
Mm-hmm. How many questions in section one were correct?
No, how many questions or the section one?
10.
Oh, 10. Mm-hmm. 10, yep, 7 or 8. Mm-hmm.
Seven or eight, good. 7 or 8, which one? Because it makes a big difference between 7 and 8 in this case.
Yep.
Okay, good. Leo, I know you were not here for section one. You just did section two, yeah?
Yes, your section two.
How many correct answers did you have for section two?
I think just 3.
So I just put 3 out of 10, not 20, okay? Because you were not here for section one. Okay,
yes.
Good. So you're welcome, Eris.
Yes, I'm correct. The 14.
14?
Yeah.
14, it's good. And tell me how many correct in the first section only.
Okay, first question. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
8 is good. Very good. Thank you. Tam, please.
11.
11. Very good. How many in section one?
7.
7. Very good. It's good. Okay. Did I ask everyone? Yes. Did I ask all of you? Yes, 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 yes. Everybody's name is here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And yes, we are 8. I will post it. Good. So I just stop share this. Oh, no, I shouldn't have stopped. What time is it?
4:08.
Good. I think something has been done for you. And now, do you see my screen?
Yep.
It's platypuses. I'm right now in the platypuses, okay? I have noticed only Mayuko and Mohammed have done their assignments. Okay, thank you so much, Mayuko and Mohammed. Mohammed is not here actually, but thank you so much, Mayuko. Please notice for the whole week that we had class together, for reading, there are some exercises, but they are optional. If you have time, you can do them. For the speaking, there is one assignment. Please do and submit it this week, because next sessions, next week, you will have new ones. Grammar is with Miss May and she knows what to do. And the listening also, you have an assignment. Do you see it here? It's written listening. And then you will see, is it a bag? What is it? You see a green sign with a white tick mark, yeah? It's an assignment for the listening. You click on it. Let me see who has done it. Oh, again, Mayuko, thank you so much. Very good. And Mohammed, yes. Mayuko and Mohammed, they have done the listening assignment as well. Other people, please do it, okay? Because next week you will have new assignments and it will be very difficult for you. Now, look at your own platypuses and tell me now, do you have this platypuses journal? Check it, please, and give me your name if you don't have it. Let me know, please. Just open platypuses. On top of the page, you can see it. Tam, did you find it? Unmute yourself, Tam. Okay. Are you in platypuses?
Yeah.
Okay. What do you see in your platypuses here about assessment and grade? Do you see it?
Yes, okay. I see.
And do you see this platypuses journal?
Yes.
Okay. So click on it.
Yes.
It opens.
Yes, open.
And you see this?
Yeah, I see.
Okay, add a discussion. Can you do it?
Okay, teacher.
Okay, good, very good. So let me ask Carol. Carol, do you have platypus's journal? I don't hear.
Yes, I got it.
Okay, you have it. Okay, have you done it or no?
No, I'll finish it on this weekend.
Okay, this weekend. Mahachi, do you have this?
Yes.
Do you see it? Okay, open it and see if you can open it. Leo, please. Do you see this?
Yes, I got it.
Oh, very good. Thank you. And Eris, do you see this platypus's journal?
Yeah, I got Miss.
Okay, Mayuko, please.
Yeah, I just posted right now.
Okay, very good. Thank you. Have you done it before previously and then you posted it?
Yesterday I wrote it, but I didn't post it. So
very good, lovely. Let's see Mayuko's. Mayuko, am I allowed to show yours?
Yeah, you can do that.
Is it okay? Okay, yeah, thank you so much. Okay, yeah. As you see, Mayuko has put journal here. Mayuko's journal M1 and 2. Very good. Thank you. Because in M1 means week one, we still didn't have access to it, but now you all have access. So we put M1 and 2 in one, but from next week, every week you are going to have it. And with her permission, I will open it. You see, she has just written something here. And probably it should be just minimum 100 words, okay? It can be about our classes here. It can be about your practices, your job, your pet, whatever, any worries, any concerns, any happiness you want to share with us. You can just write, okay? Is that clear to you?
Yeah.
Okay, so I hope that this weekend, because during the weekend, I will check all the assignments. I hope during the weekend, I receive your journals and also your assignments, okay? One speaking, one listening. This is two pieces of assignment and also a journal. Is it clear to you?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, now, do you have... Yeah, we have half an hour. Do you have grammar classes?
Yeah.
Yes, you had on Wednesday. What was the session about? What was the topic? What grammar structure did you learn?
Present perfect.
Ah, good. You learned present perfect. Yeah, okay, good. I know it. Very good. Lovely. So can you make some sentences in present perfect? Because while you're doing that, I want to play a song which is related to present perfect. And in this song, you will hear lots of present perfect sentences. And you are going to just write down some of them to us, okay? Okay, before I play the song, you just, week one, which is related to Miss May's class, grammar class. I'm ready to hear your present perfect sentences. Just one sentence in present perfect.
I have done my job very well.
Very good, lovely, thank you. Yes, I have done my job very well. Today, you mean?
In the morning.
In the morning. Okay, very good. Lovely. Thank you. What about you, Eris? Eris?
What, Miss?
Yes, one present perfect sentence.
Oh, perfect sentence.
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
Eris, I will come back to you. Think about it. Tam?
Oh. Yes, Tisha.
What were you doing when I asked you to do it?
I just opened my Assam sheet. I can't find this.
Ah, present perfect. Yeah. Okay. Let's ask Mayuko so that everyone can just think about it. Yeah.
Yes.
Any sentence?
Yeah, any sentence it can be.
I have been in Australia for 2 years.
Very good. Thank you. Lovely. I have been in Australia for 2 years. Mahachi? Unmute yourself, Mahachi.
I have studied 10 years ago. I have finished my bachelor 10 years ago. Maybe 10 not
years ago.
It's a long time.
I have finished it. Okay. Because it's not a grammar class, I'm not going to push more to give me sentences because you had it. I just wanted to remind you of this. That the song is related to the grammar structure that you had this week and you practiced with Miss May this week. Listen to this song and try to find as many as present perfect structures in the sentence, which is have plus past participle and has plus past participle. Is it clear to you? And then we will just see the lyrics and we will work on it. You can hear it?
Mountains, I have run through the fields only.
did you take notes of any present perfect verb form? You didn't? Okay, so do one thing. Listen once more. And this time, you just take notes as many as present perfect positive and negative verbs you find in the song, okay? There are lots of it. Almost all his sentences are in present perfect, positive and negative. So just try to find them and write them down. And at the end, you will just send them in the chat, or you can just put it in the chat right now. 1, 2, 3, let's go.
These city walls.
Okay, yes, write some of them in the chat box, please, for me. Oh, I have received lots of messages. Thank you, Mayuko. I have climbed, I have run, I have scaled. I haven't found very good in negative four. And I have kissed, I have spoke, very good. I have held, lovely. So many you found, thank you very much. Eris, I'm looking for, no, Eris. You're going to find only present perfect, which is have or has or the negative form.
Oh, got it.
Yeah, plus the past participle. This is what you want. This is what we want, and you need to find. Okay. Ohachi, I have scared. I have believed, maybe. So let's see. Carol, do you have?
I sent to.
Tam, who did you send it to?
I sent to Alice.
Okay, no problem. Send it to us now, to everyone. Okay, Mohachi had it. Leo, how many did you hear? Leo?
Yes.
How many did you hear? Turn your camera on.
I have the same problem that Aris.
Okay, well, what is your problem? Oh, you didn't know it. Weren't you on Wednesday's class with Miss May?
Yesterday?
Wednesday, it was yesterday. Yeah, of course, 5 to 7. Sorry, by mistake, I muted you. Sorry, just unmute yourself. yeah, good.
No, yesterday I just had.
Okay.
Spoke, not it says spoken.
Yeah, spoken. I think Mayuko is right, Mohachi. Anyways, we will see it. Okay. Mohachi. Yeah, Tam, I have kissed. I have helped. I have scared. Okay, let's see.
Spoken.
Leo, please turn your camera on. Don't keep it off. Okay. Suther, did you reach home? Would you turn your camera on, please? Okay, good. And just a second, sorry. Good. Give me nice smiles. Yeah, it's good now. 1, 2, 3. Good. Okay, let's see. I'm going to share the screen. The song is here. Yes, so it's for week one. Okay, or week two, the grammar focus of the song is present perfect tense. The name of the song is, as you see, I still haven't found what I'm looking for. And the artist, who is the artist? Do you know it? You too, yeah, the artist is you too. Okay, let's read the lyrics and see what's happening there. Mohachi, would you read the first part?
I have climbed the highest mountains.
Mm-hmm.
I have run through the fields.
Mm-hmm.
Only to be with you.
Mm-hmm.
Only to be with you.
Thank you. Now, Mayuko, you please help us and tell me how many present perfect tense did you find here?
Two.
Very good. Which ones?
I have climbed and very good. I have run.
Lovely. Perfect. Thank you. Nice. So, Tam, you read the second part, please.
I have lumps. I have crumb. Crown. Mm-hmm. I have scales. This mm-hmm. is the wall. This is the wall only to be with you.
Very good. So Mayuka was right because I remember she had a scale. Yeah. But so it's not scared much. You wrote scared. Yeah. It was scaled. Okay. And Leo, would you tell me the present perfect structures? How many do you see here?
Present perfect what? Sorry?
Present perfect. How many present perfect tenses do you see here? Okay. I don't hear you, Leo.
Three?
Okay, just tell me which ones.
I have run.
Very good. I have run.
I have crawled.
Very good. I have crawled and
I have scaled.
Very good. Lovely. Thank you. I have scaled. Perfect. Well done. Beautiful. So read it, please, Eris. And Carol, you tell us about the present perfect tenses. Eris?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Oh, okay. But I still haven't found mm-hmm. what I'm looking for. But mm-hmm. I still haven't found what I'm looking for.
Carol, how many did you find?
One.
One.
I haven't found.
Is it positive one or the negative one?
It's a negative one.
Very good. Lovely. Thank you, Carol. Read this part. And Tam, you find the present perfect, okay?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. I have kissed honey lips. Feels the feeling in her fingertips. It's burned like fire. I was burning inside her.
Very good. And Tam, how many did you find?
Three.
Which ones?
I have kissed.
Very good.
Kissed honey lips.
And your sentence was correct. Thank you. Very good. And?
I climbed scales. This is the walls. You mean in a paragraph, right, teacher?
Yeah, just in the paragraph.
Oh, there's just one only. One. Okay. I have kindness, honey lip.
Okay, good. Thank you. What about Eris? No, sorry, Leo, read this one. And Mahachi, you find the verbs.
Sure. I have spoke with the tongue of angels.
Mm-hmm.
I have held the hand of a devil.
Mm-hmm.
It was warm in the night. I was called as a stone.
Very good, thank you. As a stone. Mahachi, how many did you find?
Two.
Very good.
I have spoke and I have film. I have
very,
film.
Very
but
good.
It's I don't understand why they use I have spoke.
Because what do you mean? You need to have spoken?
Yes, in the speech for spoken.
Yeah, but some verbs are like this one, yeah. The third part can be spoken or similar to the second part. So both spoke and spoken are correct, okay?
Oh.
Mm-hmm. Good. So Mayuko, please read.
But I still haven't found what I'm looking for, but I still haven't found what I'm looking for.
Very good. How many?
One.
Very good. Two negative ones. Yeah. Very good. Thank you. Let's ask Tam.
I believe in the kingdom come. Come. Then all the colors will beat into one.
Mm-hmm.
Beat into one. Mm-hmm. But yes, I'm still running.
Did you find any?
No, not sure.
Not sure. Do we have any here?
I believe.
No. Mayuko, do we have any here?
Still running.
Any present perfect form here?
Nothing.
No, nothing. Thank you. And Leo, read this one.
You broke the bonds and you lose the chains.
Mm-hmm.
Chains carried the cross of my shame.
Mm-hmm.
All my shame, you know, I believe it. I believe it.
Mm-hmm. And Leo, do we have any here?
Any what? Sorry, I'm...
Do we have any present perfect form here? Have plus verb, has plus verb, past participle form. Do we have?
I'm not sure, maybe.
No, we don't.
No.
No, we don't. Okay, who is here who didn't read? Carol, please. Carol, finish it, please.
Start from the first one or second.
Both are the same, just read one of them.
But I still haven't found what I'm looking for. But I still haven't found what I'm looking for.
Very good, thank you. How many?
Just one.
Yeah, one, but repeated two times. Very good, thank you. So, and this is the table that you need to complete, but you don't need to complete because you already did it in the chat. So that's enough, good. And generally, did you like the song? Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes, and do you know you too?
Yes, of course.
Okay, do you listen to them?
Not the moment, no, but yes, I listen the songs.
Okay, what do you listen to at the moment? Who is your favorite at the moment?
Maybe deep house or techno music.
Mm-hmm. Okay, good, lovely, thank you. And so, Mayuko, what was the song about? What was he just telling repeatedly? What was the song about? What was he telling? Just what was he repeating all the time?
Oh, he repeated.
Mm-hmm.
What was that? He still find.
Uh-huh.
What he's looking for.
Very good. Yes, he was repeating that he still hasn't found what he was looking for. What about you? Have you found what you were looking for? And he's sitting there, so we cannot talk about it. Okay, good. So it seems that you have found. Yes, Mayuko.
Yeah.
Okay, good. Let's ask Tam, have you found what you were looking for?
I'm looking for...
We are talking about the person, okay? Probably your boyfriend, yeah. Your partner, or someone like that, okay? Have you found the one that you were looking for?
Yes, I found this.
Okay, good. So, Tam, tell us, what qualities were you looking for in a partner?
This one quality for like a good person only, and good. honest uh-huh. Person. Yeah.
Good. So you were looking for honesty. Very good. Thank you. And you found it.
Yes, I found it.
Oh, congratulations. I'm really happy for you. You were looking for honesty and you have it. Okay, Mahachi, what about you? Have you found what you were looking for?
Yeah,
good. And you have her?
No.
So how did you find?
I find it who can teach me to approve my meditation.
Okay, so you're not looking for a partner, you're looking for someone to teach you something. Yeah,
when we have the partner, we have a problem.
Oh my God, when we have partner, we have problem. Did you notice what he said? Oh my God. Mayuko, do you agree with him? He said that when we have partner, we have problem.
Yeah. Yes.
You agree? Oh my God.
Sorry.
How can you say that? Good, good, good. And Mayuko, what qualities were you looking for in a partner?
Nothing special, because he's helping a lot.
Okay, good.
Don't talk anymore.
Okay, he's helping a lot. That's enough for her. That's good. Let's ask Carol. Carol, have you found what you were looking for?
I don't know.
You don't know. Carol, are you married?
Yes, but I don't think about this.
Okay, you haven't thought about it. Okay, something happened there to Mayuko, probably. Yes, this question just, you know, caused a lot of trouble there. Okay.
How about the teacher?
How about the teacher?
No, how about you?
How about me? Yeah, but the point is that what we are looking for, we need to find in ourselves, not in others. This is the point, you know, Margie? Yeah, we need search it inside us, not in
really
others.
True. Really yeah, true. Really yeah, true. Yeah. The answer should be.
Yeah, good, thank you. Okay, guys, you can just leave the class, enjoy a 15-minute break, and then join the other classes. Mayuko, I hope my question didn't cause any troubles there for you.
Yes. Yeah. Use the barista drinks ever.
Oh my god. Okay, take care of yourself. I hope nothing happens to you today. Give me a call if anything happened, okay?
Yeah.
Thank you, everybody. Have a good weekend. See you later. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.